Welcome to Tylervision Intense TV. I'm your host, Robert Lewis Tyler First. And today, we have a very special episode of Tylervision Talk Show Live. We have on the set today, we have the legend, the man, the myth, Ronnie Hudson will be here today. We have Sherrie Taylor is going to be on the show today. And out of Southern California, we're going to have Hemet Radio from HemetRadio.com. Eddie George will be on the show today. And I was just going to tell you, you heard that song, you know, California knows how to party. That's the Ronnie Hudson platinum one, right? You know, so, you know, Ronnie Hudson, you know, I snagged this off of his car earlier today. Rolling in a Rolls Royce, Cadillac, leaning in Mercedes Benz. So anyway, last night I had the little celebrity birthday get together, and it was with Sherrie Taylor was there, and the author of the best-selling books, D.G. Spillman was there, and the legends of hip-hop, rap, jazz, R&B, soul, funk, and gospel was Ronnie Hudson. Harvey Scales was there. He wrote that Disco Lady. And he wrote, and then we had B.B. Adele was there. Eddie George was there from Hemet Radio, and the lovely and talented Susie Sansom was there. And then we went down to Downtown Joe's after that, right, to the club. So I was going to do a shout out to Downtown Joe's. So I go Downtown Joe's and I said, hey, you know, so we're going to do a promo. So we did autograph sign-in. We got some CDs, autographed pictures, and you know, I thought, well, you know, and I got Ronnie Hudson a new hoodie. So I grab him a new hoodie. It's a fur-lined hoodie, right? So I grab him one of those and bought him one for my birthday. So we did the autograph sign. We went up the VIP room at Downtown Joe's and brought some people up, did some autographs and stuff, and make a little money on the side, right? So we're setting that up. And then I said, well, I'm gonna get free sodas, right? And some chicken wings, right? And they're like, absolutely. So thanks to Downtown Joe's setting us up there in the VIP room. I appreciate that. Jarvis Jones told me to give a little shout out to Leela and the young performers, you know? So first I wanna introduce tonight, the one and only Ronnie Hudson. Ronnie, welcome on the show. How you been, man?
I'm fine, how are you?
Good, you know, it's always a pleasure to work with you.
And thank you for having me here.
Thanks for being here, you know. How was the ride up? Is it all right?
The ride
from Los Angeles.
The ride was good, and saw many fascinating things along the way.
Nice. But, yeah. How many hours did it take you?
It took about 5.5.
Yeah. Wow, yeah. You were flying.
Yeah, we were getting it, you know. We only did, we've got 160 on the speedometer. We only did 140.
Yeah?
Yeah.
About 140?
Yeah, we sort of cruised down here.
Now, what's this down below? Is this like a platinum album you got?
That is, yes, it's a platinum, a multi-platinum.
Multi-platinum, I'm sorry.
Yes, sir. it's from the West Coast pop block song, which many people have did their version of once I completed it. And
boy,
this is the version that Tupac did, which was entitled California Love.
Oh, the one with Dre and Snoop?
Dre, Snoop.
And Tupac.
And Tupac, Roger Troutman, and the Klan.
Nice.
And
Troutman was on there too?
Yeah, yeah, Troutman was on there.
Nice.
Yeah.
And that was in 92 when they remixed that, right?
I believe
around that
95.
Or was it that late?
96, yeah. Something like
that's
that.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but it was the number one hit. It was West Coast pop rock in 1982. Correct me if I'm wrong.
That is correct.
Right. And I was going to ask you about, and that went multi-platinum. And oh yeah, remember the San Andreas, the Grand Theft Auto, the GTA video game the kids have played?
I do.
And that movie Chef that just dropped?
I do.
And the movie A Million Ways to Die in the West Coast or something?
A Million right? Ways to Die in the West, yeah. Yeah.
And, uh-huh. and those two movies just dropped. What song was in there?
Well, good question.
Was it California
ways,
Love?
The Million Ways to Die in the West, they used the California Love.
Nice.
And on Chef, they use West Coast Pop Lock.
Which is the same song, basically.
Which is
just
the
has
same
a little bit different lyrics.
Yeah, and the
switched up a little.
Different artists.
The remix.
Yeah,
fix it in the mix, right?
Yes, sir.
So, and speaking of chef, you know the guy that plays chef on South Park is a cat, you know, right? Isaac Hayes? Right?
That's someone I know. I had the privilege of working with Isaac Hayes during the 70s. And at that particular time, he actually became a superstar and had the opportunity of playing on his material in the studios of Stax Records. And
I was just going to mention Stax Records.
Yeah. And I actually became the bass player, one of the recording bass players for Stax Records.
Nice.
In which I did many recordings. And it was a learning experience and a good experience.
So how did it feel to work with Stax Records and Isaac and these cats? You
know? Working with those guys, I saw some miracle things happen in these studios, because during those days we didn't have 8 tracks and right. all of that sort of thing. We only had 2 tracks, and you know, if you're playing, you have the symphony orchestra sitting there, and you have the 13-piece rhythm section sitting here, and everybody had to play, and there could not be not one mistake.
Right, because
If there was one mistake, then everything starts over again.
Right, right.
You have to do it from the beginning. And
and I was going to say, in Stax Records, you know, in Memphis, when you were with Isaac Hayes and Elvis Presley, right?
Mm-hmm.
You tell me about a little bit about that
story.
Elvis,
I can never say enough great things about him. He was a humanitarian, first of all. Of course, there were a lot of things said about him that was not true.
I like to
sit the negative thing. I like to sit the record straight and say that he was one of the most decent personalities that I ever met. He had a heart of gold. They tried to say something about him not liking blacks
and Mexicans.
Yeah, and things like that. But his whole band was black,
right.
And he did so much for the black neighborhood. And I would just like to set the record straight on that and say that he was one of the better people that I ever had a chance to meet.
Thanks. I'm glad you said that and stood up for him.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. Great guy.
That's fantastic.
And I had the privilege of going to his home.
Yeah.
And we sat at his table and
nice.
Had dinner with him. And we were served by the house mm-hmm. people. And it was an honor and a pleasure to be able to do something like that.
Did he say, "Mama, pass the mayonnaise"? Did you guys have fried bananas
well,
and peanut butter?
He actually said, "You can do anything, but don't step on my blue sweet pea."
Now we were talking about. I think it was me and Sherrie Taylor. Weren't we talking about, was it you I was talking to about Rufus Thomas?
No.
I was talking to BB Scales
about
Rufus Thomas. Now, Rufus Thomas, I didn't know, I was talking about this last night at the birthday party, you know, it was like a celebrity get together. And Sherrie Taylor was there, and BB Scales, and Harvey Scales, a legend, right, you know. And also Eddie George, right, from Hemet Radio, here in the studio. Was there, and I was talking to BB about Rufus Thompson when I'd seen him on Soul Train, you know, and doing the funky chick. I had no idea that you worked with him, right? Now today I find out you worked with that cat. Too,
yes,
right?
I did his recordings in the studio. Again, he was a Stax artist. I'm a Stax bass player, and he came. I worked with him on a song called "The Breakdown." And he came into the studio. He said, "Break it on down, break it, break it, break it, hop it through the break it." And it just wasn't getting it, right? And he looked at us, myself, Willie Hall, Charles Pitts, guitar player, played Shaft.
Yeah.
And he says, "Listen, what can you guys give me?" And I had this little funky bass line I had in my head I wanted to do for so long, never had a chance to do it.
It's a perfect opportunity.
Perfect opportunity. So I'm going like boom, doom, doom, doo, doo, doo. And I started playing that on the bass, and Willie Hall just came in with the drums, and Charles Pitts came in. We call him Skip. He came and said, and we had the breakdown. We jammed that song for so long, and right in the studio. And you know, during those days, we didn't take the time to sit down and write lyrics and all that stuff. You know, Rufus Thomas made the lyrics up while he was singing the song. These people were super talented.
Right.
They could
just
do
gifted
this.
And blessed.
Gifted,
and
yes.
Come right out, right?
Now, and then we had the breakdown. It came out. It sold so many millions of copies. It's incredible.
Yeah, he played at, what was it, Wattstock?
Wattstacks. Yeah.
Yeah, did that have something to do with Stax Records?
It had a
kind of, sort of?
A lot to do with Stax.
That was a wild concert, yeah.
Yeah, it was. And as you know, the L.A. riots had taken place.
Right.
And there was no control over it.
Yeah, I noticed that.
People had gone stone mad.
They went wild in the streets,
man. They were wild, man, doing all sorts of stuff. And Stax said, well, let's Jim Stewart, who was the CEO of Stax, he had a lot to do with this.
Yeah.
And he says, let's go to Watts and over there and let's calm the people down. Let's give them a show that they can come to. Free
show
tickets.
Them some love, right?
Nobody has to pay to come in.
Yeah.
And show them some love.
Right.
So we go there, and of course we put on this huge concert, and we have so many important people, VIPs there. And then we had David Porter, which was one of the senior writers for Stax. And he and Isaac Hayes finally went to the Hall of Fame for their contributions to production in Stax. And these people came out. Reverend Jesse Jackson came out and did some MCing for us. And it calmed the people down, and the riots were done at that point.
Right,
it was over, and the people had a very good time.
Now the city of Watts and Compton, they said that you showed them much love too on the flip the script side, right? Right. You know, they said no one's ever kind of showed us love like this before, right? You know,
that's what they told me. I actually, when my manager Michael Hooks came to me, he says, he had a title called West Coast Pop Lock. He said, can you write this? I said, sure, I'm certain I can. And he says, okay, put something about Watts, Compton, and LA, and put something in there about that. And I said, okay. And then he took off. So the only way I could put that in there, I would have to go out to Watts and Compton and do research.
Check it out.
And find out what it is that I could write about these people. So when I went to do my research, I went to Watts first, and I learned that these people that were supposed to be hard and gangsters and these type of people that was hard, I learned that they needed love.
Right.
I learned this from them, and this is why the gangs formed, because they wanted people to, they needed somebody to love. Most of these guys didn't have any parents, or they would have a mom and no dad. We need fatherly love and guidance. But most of the fellas that I met, the mom was the mother and father.
Yeah, of the
and
family.
They would say Happy Father's Day to her and Happy Father's Day to her.
Mm-hmm.
So when I saw that, it just touched me, and I wanted to find out more. So I began to speak with the gangsters, and they were telling me how there's no love for them. And I told them, I said, well, listen, I'm going to go back and write a song, and I'm going to show you everlasting love, because I'm going to put something in my song about you all over here, and show you that somebody cares. And that we do love you. And they say, well, nobody's ever shown us anything like that.
Right, right.
So I go to Compton, and pretty much the same thing happened there. And they were they treated me like royalty that day. There was no fighting. The gangsters didn't fight. Bloods, the Crips, everybody came together as a family. And I think I brought unity for that day.
I think you did. Yeah, yeah.
And it was a beautiful day, and something that never been, no one had ever been successful
right.
at doing something like this. But that wasn't my goal to
right,
do
right.
that.
Is this a research and,
yeah,
and feel
the
out
research.
The vibe and keep the kind of a
exactly.
feeling about the people, and that's mm-hmm. how you felt, and that's how they felt.
And,
it was mutual.
Exactly.
Love.
But when I left, I had so much, I just, my heart was just, it was. I couldn't, I didn't want to leave. And I discovered that, you know, people would say that was the ghetto, but I discovered that the ghetto is not it where you live, it's in the
right,
person.
Right.
That I learned that by being there.
Yeah, you can take the people out of the ghetto, you can't take the ghetto out of the people, right?
And that's a great saying, because while I was there, I noticed that there were people that had Mercedes Benz.
Right.
And you go, if you were to go inside one of the apartments, it mm-hmm. was very nice.
Yeah.
But they just, that's the only place they could do that.
The only place they could keep nice.
I'm exactly.
I lived in a neighborhood mm-hmm. like that in Moreno Valley in mm-hmm. the 80s, in the mid 80s, and it was like the height of the crack epidemic, mm-hmm. right? I'm the only, there's all Crip neighborhood, and I just moved in. The rent was cheap, I didn't know, and then the guy came in, turned on the gas, and he goes, you know where you're at? And I'm like, it's like Hugh Street. They had to change the name because it was so scary. It's not called Hugh Street anymore. And people get murdered. It's like all Crip neighborhood. So, you know, and the guy came in, turned on the gas. He goes, I went to school with these fools, and I'm not staying in the neighborhood tonight. You know, and he's a big old dude, you know. He's like, and so he said, they'll rob their own mother, you know. So, it's like, so, you know, he left. But you go in their house, they had all this money from... They'd been dealing, right? The inside house, beautiful, right? But you go outside, it's broken glass everywhere.
Wow.
So, right, you know, it's like,
yeah.
So I lived there about 6 months, and I lived, so. But it was a pretty scary neighborhood. You could drive-by shootings and stuff.
Yeah, Compton and Watts were pretty much like that.
Mm-hmm.
But
well, they had all moved out from Compton to Moreno Valley.
Mm-hmm.
And South Central and mm-hmm. Hoover Street Crips were there, mm-hmm. and you know the, you know Crenshaw and mm-hmm. you know mm-hmm. Watts, all the Compton South Central, come out to Moreno Valley. It's a gangster's paradise out there. It's open territory.
Let's do it.
So, but the inside houses were like plush. You know? So,
but you know when I left mm-hmm. from there, I had. My whole life had was changed. I came out of there a different person than, you know, before I went in. And I came out, while I was there, they played lots of music, and they partied, they smoked weed, they did everything. they had...
Can't say weed on TV. Okay. No, I'm just...
They had girls come over and sit with me, and you know, made me
nice.
Comfortable.
So it's touched your heart,
and you
touched their heart as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, it was incredible.
You know, I got the Tammy Awards, you know, music awards for television artists, you know, television awards, music of the month, y'all, and so the Tammy Awards. So today's nominees are, let's see, looks like B.B. Adele and Harvey Scales, right? So the winner is, looks like, oh, B.B. Adele, accepting the award for B.B. Adele is Sherrie Taylor.
All right.
Did you write an acceptance speech or anything?
Well, yeah? I can say that this is well deserved.
Okay.
And BB will definitely be happy with this.
Thank
She's
you.
Been very
accepting
grateful.
That on her behalf. She
you know, I'm so
gracious
sorry
enough.
That she couldn't make
she
it.
She got a little caught in traffic.
But
and,
yeah.
And Harvey Scales, the legend, Harvey Scales. This was the
yeah.
legend show. He's caught in traffic in somewhere in San Francisco right now, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And also, you know, we also had the Pioneer Rap Award, which goes to Ronnie Hudson.
Well, right here, thank you. Know, and,
all right.
Thank you.
Thank you,
sir.
Thank you so much.
It's an honor to work with you. And it's a pleasure to work with you anytime. We'll have to do this again real soon, maybe next
yes.
week.
Yes.
And our next award goes to Jay Black, who did the vocals on Ronnie Hudson's album. And he did a couple of tracks on it, you know. So Jay Black out of Sacramento, this one's for you, right? Accepting the award for Jay Black tonight will be Eddie George. No, I'm just kidding.
I won't give it to him. I'll keep it.
Sherrie Taylor here is a vocalist and recording artist. She's got to go do her CD signing tonight in Oakland and then in Oaktown. And then she's got to go straight in at 11 for other appointments as well. So how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing great.
Good.
I'm going to a CD party.
Right.
And afterwards, I go to work. I work for HealthRight 360.
Nice.
And what I do is I'm a counselor for women and children who are recovering addicts and alcoholics.
Nice. That's
and I love my work, you know. I love my music, but I love saving lives as well.
Oh, yeah, that's important,
and,
right?
And it's very important, I would say.
Because you're giving back to the community.
I'm giving back to what was so freely given to me. And I'll be the first to admit that I am a recovering addict myself.
I'm
okay. In the past 5.5 years, I've been clean and sober, and
I only got 3 years. So,
oh, congrats! You know, and I can say that my blessings are coming.
Oh yeah.
You know, slowly but surely they do come. That
aren't
man upstairs
the floodgates are open.
Oh, the floodgates are
the
really open.
The blessings are rolling in.
I also sing with the Glide Choir. And that's what the CD party is for tonight,
from
the Glide Choir. And I will be doing a show on the 11th. On the second Saturday of every month, I perform at Martuni's in San Francisco.
Oh, really?
With the San Francisco Recovery Theater.
Nice.
And what the San Francisco Recovery Theater is, we do shows from, I'm sure you guys all remember, the Black Hawk Theater.
Mm-hmm.
From years and the Black Hawk Theater is where many talented artists first got their beginning, you know.
Right.
And we do different shows about them, you know. We're based out of the Tenderloin in San Francisco, but
nice.
it's a really nice show. I would love for you guys to come and join us the second Saturday of every month.
Thanks for inviting us.
Yes, you know, it's great.
I want to go.
Sure, please come, all of you.
I'm gonna let Eddie hold this because he looked like he got nothing.
Oh man, you make me
put that on
so
your lap
here, Robert.
You guys get like tripping.
You can look us up at the San Francisco www San Francisco Recovery Theater.
Okay.
Okay, and check it out. I think you'll like it.
Sounds like a plan, right?
So
we went to after we left you, you know, at the birthday party. We went over to Downtown Joe's, right? You know, this I won't tell about that. A little gang thing. No, I'm not going to do no bad press for me. No, I'm just joking. Last time I saw a girl in there dancing almost naked, and I was like, no, I better not say that on TV. Then everybody go there, right? Right?
Yeah.
So, but these girls, they said, hey, you know, they're talking about me and Eddie, and they said, are you guys brothers? And I said, no, we're white. He said, he's my sister from a distant mister, you know.
That's all right.
And they thought we were brothers. You know? I mean, my skin's tan, but, you know, like, not that tan, right? You know,
so. Brother from another mother, right?
Yeah. Sister from a distant mister. You know? So we're sorry that... who is going to come on? B.B. Adele.
B.B.
And we're going to have Harvey Scales, the legend, right? And we were going to have Ricky Ricardo Scales on. And was Captain Rap coming out today?
I don't believe they're not going to be able to make it. Yeah.
I don't think so.
Yeah, no.
I typed him in the credits anyway, so shout out to Captain Rap,
and
DJ Flash, the producers, producers.
Flash.
Not from the movie, the producers, but
right.
the music. So, you know, it's Captain Flash and I mean, DJ Flash and Captain Rap and, wait, I got a list, right? I got a cheat sheet. Oh, Danny Means didn't show up either. No, he's the guitar player. He's the guitarist, a good friend of yours, right?
Yeah.
Well, he will be, anyway. And Bernadine Southall Evans, Jarvis Jones, you know, and so we had like 10 with me, 11, my co-host, there's 12 people would have been on the show. Mm-hmm. So it kind of worked out nice, just having a nice little tight, close crowd and a little intimate BB. So I had like a little quiet conversation with you guys, you know, a little intimate. Mm-hmm. And that's her now. She's here. No, that was my cameraman. She's not coming. she had to cook dinner. So, so we got about
on the freeway.
Yeah, it's one of my cameramen. Now we got about 5 minutes left. So I got a little bio here too, right? You know, it says a little bit about Signs of the Times, right? Is that the gospel? No, is that the gospel album?
That's the gospel.
That's the one
that I'm going to record.
Can you tell me a little bit about the Street People as well and that?
The Street People. Is the band, the group that I used to record the West Coast Pop Lock.
Okay.
And once that was done, then of course we did tours and so forth. But we hung together for many years, and we performed the West Coast Pop Lock all over the place.
Nice.
A very nice group, very good group of people. And finally, people started getting old.
Really?
And dropping off one at a time. So
what's up with that?
So I finally
like we all do sometimes.
Yeah, so I, you know, I'm by me still being out there. So I formed another group, and now I have a band. It's called Ronnie Hudson and the Badass Band.
Nice.
Yeah.
I like that.
Boy, okay.
Now, who's this cat you brought with you from Hemet Radio? Is this Eddie George over here?
This is my protege.
Is he your protege?
Yes, sir.
Is your associate? Now you have a radio station in down in Hemet, Southern
Hemet
California,
radio,
SoCal.
It's HemetRadio.com. It's internet worldwide radio. We've got followers all over different countries, all over the world. And what we do is we promote only music artists that are unsigned. And I use Ronnie Hudson. He's one of our headliners, basically. And we're doing a reality show.
Right.
And it's called The Crazy Guy with the Lazy Eye.
Nice.
And I go behind the scenes, showing, you know, what the legends do on and off stage, their daily lifestyle.
I'll
show you on national TV what Ronnie Hudson does, you know.
What do you have for breakfast?
Exactly.
What
he has for breakfast.
If any.
Exactly. Right. I'll even show you how he puts the socks on in the morning, folks. And it's not normal. Let me tell you, I was surprised. So you can definitely follow my shows on him at radio.com. You can follow me on Facebook at facebook.com/HemetRadio. That's H-E-M-E-T radio. And we'll be broadcasting our reality show as well on the communitytv.com as well. So, we're actually broadcasting this show live on the communitytv.com right now.
Nice.
So, television TV, just click on the tab and you'll see it.
So does he drive Rolls Royce,
Cadillac,
Lincoln, or Mercedes?
That's
which
right.
one is he driving?
All three of them, man. Depending on how he feels that
not
day,
at
what
the same
car
time,
he wants to use. Not at the same time, though.
Yeah.
That's right.
In the city of Compton, we pop lock. So we got like 2 minutes left and we got to wrap it up, so I got to do some shout outs real quick. And I want to tell you real quick, right about here, right about now, boy howdy, celebrity guest of the television show, stay at the Magnolia House right here, the vacation spot for the high-end clientele in the Napa Valley. Transportation provided by Rolls Royce, Cadillac, Lincoln, and Mercedes. I've been chauffeuring this guy around in his Cadillac for 2 days now, right? So we got in at 2 a.m, right? So we'd like to thank our guest, Ronnie Hudson, right here, Eddie George, and Sherrie Taylor right here. And you know, everything he does goes gold, then it goes to platinum. He's got that Midas touch right here. And I want to thank our sponsor, Sal the Flower Guy, brings these flowers in every week fresh. Doc's Trophy Shop brings in these music awards every time for our musical performing guests. And Hair in Motion does my hair, right? And Dr. Moore adjusts my back. Susie Sanson provides those vacation condos right here in town, right? For my live celebrity guests in the live studio here. And Downtown Joe's, thanks for the hot, what were they called, hot wings?
Hot wings.
Is that the word for it, hot wings? Yeah, I called them chicken wings, but they were hot, spicy.
Were
and the free sodas. Go, free sodas and some chicken. Absolutely. And I was like, okay. So I want to thank our live studio audience here. You know, TC's in the house. We got BB Adele's in the house. And we got, want to thank our TV audience, Napa Valley TV audience as well in the Bay Area. Best in the world, right? Best audience in the world. Our online, live streaming worldwide, internationally. And you know, Ronnie's on his worldwide whirlwind tour right now. So we got free smartphones and iPhones for everybody here in the studio today. I made sure I bought one for everybody. So you get a phone, you get a phone, and you get a phone, right? And I also got, like, I thought, you know, we could go pick a card, any card, right? You know, so I got some cards for you guys, some little gift cards. And of course, you always get the autographed headshots, you know, and stuff like that. This one was for your buddy, right? That's for Danny Thomas out of Confunction. He forgot, he left it here, you know? So he's like, I was like, let it ring up in here, you know? So pretty much we're out of here. We'll roll some credits, and until next time, America. So it's always a pleasure working with you. God bless you and yours, pretty much. We're a space coast from the West Coast, right? So, you know, I'll get it. It's probably for me.